please subscribe, like, comment, and turn on the notification button so you are aware of our future.
Hello everyone, welcome to another Film Biz Show conversation right in the heart of MIP Africa 2024. Today, we're talking to a titan of this business, a woman who's literally shifted mountains and stands on a hill which oversees so many careers, and she really is someone who's held a torch for us in this business. Today, we're speaking to Harriet Goffshaw.
Thank you for joining us. Thank you. I mean, this.
I was sitting in the panel where you were discussing, the viability of local content in the international market, and it made me think, my goodness, the conversations you're having are actually very high level. You know, where did it all start with Quizzical Pictures? How did the story, that seed that was planted, and for it to get to where it is today? What kind of hurdles did you have to jump as a female in this business?
Well, the hurdles I've jumped would have been the same if I was a man or a woman. This is a tough business. And if people ask me, like, oh, how did I get here? What's the secret? It's just like, I think I always say it's about endurance. It's just doing it over and over and over again. You know, I've been around a long time, as you can see. And it's just like not giving up. It was just never an option, right? So this is like, failure was never an option. It's like, not that, you know, and it's certainly not overnight. You know, there's no overnight success. And also, just, you know, you can be successful in one project, but then the next day you have to start another one, and it's like a clean slate. You know what I mean? It's like, you learn about from your mistakes all the way along, but it's every project is new. And I started many, like 30, 35 years ago.
Well done.
And with little projects, you know, just like the things I had, you know, like small burning projects. And yeah, and then it was just doing one after the other. And, you know, and that's how I began.
It's wonderful. I mean,
collaborations, working with other people. You know, it's really important. I mean, you know, it's our business. You know,
a lot of people find that challenging as well, because people like to be the domineering voice in the room.
Yeah.
How do you negotiate those different voices that are happening as you're collaborating?
Yeah, no, it's tough. And I mean, I think maybe that's where it's an advantage, being a woman. I don't have to be the most important voice in the room. Often not. I'm sort of in my head, it's like eyes on the prize, you know, what do I want out of this situation? I want it to be made. I want it to be made well. I mean, I'm only about the work, you know what I mean? It's like, can I look at myself in the mirror if I do, you know, a bad piece of work? No, I can't, you know.
Yeah.
So I don't have to be the loudest voice, you know, I try only to talk when I've got something to say.
Now, I mean, the landscape is changing. You know, there's a lot of international co-productions that are now happening, and the dynamics thereof are changing as well. I mean, we recently had the Minister of Arts and Culture and Sports sign a new partnership agreement with Canada. And as we speak now, we're waiting to see a panel discussion between South Africa, Jamaica, and Canada. What do you make of all these different shifting pieces, and where does that place you as Quizzical Pictures in the conversation?
Well, I think that, I mean, one thing the streamers have done is that it's internationalized content. We watch films and TV series from Sweden, from Brazil, from Spain. You know, that's a fantastic thing, you know. We're not just watching English language content, we're watching content from all over. And So it does mean that the world has opened up to our stories, which you know, I mean, we've been around for a long time, and we've been trying to get international work for many, many years, you know. And it's really only in the last maybe 6 years that I've felt that, well, you know, there's a space for us. There's a space for us to tell South African stories, and that they can be seen and appreciated internationally. And that's a fantastic feeling. And then now, I mean, I think, you know, actually, I think our business is in quite a lot of trouble now. I mean, it's certainly all over the world. It's not you know, it's tough times, I think, now. But the advantage of being us is that, first of all, we're open to collaborations. As South Africans, we're not us. We're open to collaborations. We can still produce really well and cost-effectively in South Africa. So I'm hoping that will carry us, you know, through the next, you know, year or so when the times are tough, that actually there's a space for us to produce very high quality work at a very reasonable price.
What do you think are the actual root causes for this domino effect that's happening globally, that's affecting our business? So where does it all come from? You know, this tough time that we're facing, and it seems like, you know, we as we go into the new year, we're hoping that things will turn around, but it doesn't seem like they might soon. I mean, there are wars that are kind of, you know, threatening to happen and everyone is scared. What's the reason why there isn't money flowing as much as we'd like to see?
Well, I think in South Africa, it was a big blow. The Amazon pullout was a big blow. Mm. So I think that's been really tough on many people, right? I think the SABC's troubles is a big blow. I mean, I feel it all the time because SABC, which is my breeding ground, it's where I got my break, and that's where so many people have got their breaks. And so I don't know where young people get that break, you know, get to produce something of their own for the first time without the SABC, you know. I don't know where ETV is, I can't comment on that. And then there's multi-choice has also got its own issues, I suppose, it's dealing with at the moment. So I think the combination of all of this has just meant that the times are a little tough. Also, there's very much less money around now in South Africa, right? Internationally, it's having as hard a time, if not worse, you know? So I think how I understand it is that it's a combination of the writer's strike and COVID and, you know, all of those big events happening on top of each other. Plus the fact that there was a golden period where everybody wanted content, right? Disney was there, you know, Amazon and, all the media companies also started their own streamers, right? Yeah. Competing with Netflix. And then they stopped. So they were holding back content, right, for their own use. But then that stopped, right? Apple, Disney, they decided to release their own material into the marketplace. So there's like a glut of material in the marketplace, you know, because Disney's not holding back its material, Apple's not holding back its material, et cetera, et cetera. So I think we already keep saying 2025 it'll change, 2025 it'll change, and let's hope it does.
Yeah.
But I think filmmakers all over the world are having a hard time.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Streaming has changed the business. I mean, they do say film is a director's medium, television and film. Television is a producer's medium, from what they say. But now with streaming coming into place, it's kind of blurred the lines. Mm-hmm. And I've seen a lot of discontent to directors who feel as if, you know, they're unable to make their material the way they see it because of the dynamics that streaming brings into play. What do you think about that?
I think it is interesting. I think it's combined with the fact that cinema, you know, four walls, is also struggling, right?
So since
COVID, I don't think it's ever recovered.
So it's do you think it will ever make a full-on comeback?
I don't know. I don't know whether it will.
Same, yeah. I reserve my comments.
So, you know, whereas when the film being a director's medium, I think referred to like cinema being shown in a cinema, in a four wheel, you know, that. But, you know, you now can make films for the streamers and for broadcasters, and it's their property, it's their airtime. Of course, you can't be an auteur. I mean, unless you're like one of those top tier directors. So in a way, it's treated a little like a different form of television, right? So, of course, there are people who have very strong ideas about what they want or what they need on their channel. It's very competitive now. So yes, you can't just do your own thing anymore. I don't think so. Yeah. If you I always say, because I'm a producer, so I'm very practical. So you say, if you want to do anything, write a book. Or pick up, you know, if you want to be an artist and not be
a paintbrush.
Yeah, if you not be working on anyone else around you.
It's true.
You know, then do your own thing. But I mean, we're in a business, right?
And a collaborative one.
We're in a collaborative business, and we often using other people's money. So you have to be mindful of that.
And I find creatives can be the most selfish people at times. Like, oh, this is how I want to do it.
Yeah.
And in fact, you know, it's different because we have to get things done.
Yeah. And you have to find an audience.
Oh, man.
Your broadcaster has to find an audience. Everybody's just trying to do their job.
How do you handle the stress levels, though? What's your process? Like, you have a special spa place where you know you go?
What do I do?
Yoga practice.
From work, it's like everybody can't talk to me for 15 minutes.
Love that.
It's just like, oh, please, I just need to decompress, you know?
Yeah.
But I actually try not to get stressed. You know, I've got a mantra in my company. It's like, is anybody dead? No?
No.
Is the camera rolling? No. Yes. Okay, well, then that's fine. It's not a crisis. It's just not a job. It's not a crisis.
Yeah.
You have to remind yourself, it's not brain surgery. You know, is everyone okay? As long as everyone is okay.
Don't take it so serious.
Don't,
you know, you still have a life. You're still breathing.
Yeah.
Be thankful.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we have to remember that, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, because, I mean, as human beings, we get so into all of this and we forget that there's so much to be thankful for.
Yeah.
Okay, that's really amazing, Harriet. I mean, for any upcoming producers who want to enter this space, I know it's a hard ask for me to ask you to say something to them, because, you know, the landscape isn't looking very promising at the moment.
Yeah.
But what kind of advice would you like to give them, someone who's looking at you out there and say, that's the woman I want to be?
Just keep going. And, you know, I'm very good at, like, filtering out, like, criticism.
Naturally.
Read bad reviews. It's just like just keep going. Eyes on the prize, you know. That's very much. And then also, I have the sense that, you know, what you get what you put out, you know. It will come back to you one way or another, you know. So there's a bigger plan. You know, I'm not a religious person, but there's a bigger plan.
Yeah.
Put out something and hopefully it'll come back at some point and bear out, you know. But mostly for a young producer, it's just one foot in front of the other. Just keep going, you know. Then do it again and do it again. And you'll get better and better and it'll get easier and people will know you, you know. It's not, I mean, certainly I have, that's my secret sauce. It's endurance. Just like keep at it, you know. Then you get better at it. Mm. It's easy. Well, you don't get better next year, but it gets easier.
That's true.
You know?
That's true.
Yeah.
Any upcoming work that we should be on the lookout for? Physical pictures?
Well, we've got a few nice features coming.
Wonderful.
And we've got a very nice Australian co-production, which we are going to do in the new year.
Okay.
In Cape Town.
Well, Harriet, thank you so much. This hopefully is the beginning of many conversations that we want to have with you. You know, my business partner Kevin Kumalo started from your hands.
I know.
You know, so our relationship with you, our affiliation, the way we feel about you, Harriet, from the Film Biz Show, we really see you as someone who we can continue to learn from. You're a library of knowledge. You're someone we feel has to be preserved. And from the Film Biz Show, from the bottom of our hearts, we'd like to give you your flowers and celebrate you and salute you for the titan that you are in this business. Thank you so much, Harriet.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure. What a great conversation. Thank you.